What's up, YouTube? Welcome to the Aviators channel. Flying solo today in the RV. And I thought we'd do a video on the systems we've got in here. And going to do a little bit of a cross country. And it'll be a fun time. Hang with us. All right, so we got ATIS here. Everything's in the green. Let's taxi out there. Front range ground, experimental 3105 Lima. I'm holding short at Alpha 7 for a 26 departure. I've got the current ATIS information Delta, and I'll be east out of the pattern.
Experimental 3105 Lima, front range ground, runway 26, taxi via Alpha.
3105 Lima via Alpha to 26, thanks.
Experimental 3105 Lima, follow the bonanza on the upwind for a right downwind departure, 26, clear for takeoff.
3105 Lima, we'll follow the bonanza for a right hand turnout, thanks. So here we are, flying along in the RV, heading out to kind of near Nebraska. Beautiful day for this. Weather was kind of crappy first thing, but it's good now. We said we'd do a video about the RV and all the systems it's got. It's pretty much a steam gauge stick and rudder airplane, which is just the way we like it. I've been flying this airplane for about, I'd say, two and a half years, and absolutely love it. Got it from a builder who had built several down in Arizona, and, you know, if none of you have ever looked at Van's products, I mean, the RV-7A is just a great two-seat airplane. It's fun to fly, got great performance. You know, it very light stick and rudder forces required. The way we have this one equipped is, like I said, mostly steam gauges. We do have a dyne in here, and I'm going to kind of walk through all of the systems here. But I'm going to wait to do that until we get a little bit farther out. At about 6,200 feet, I've got about an hour and a half flight here. So stay tuned. So here we are, flying along in the RV. Great day for flying. Got a little bit of clouds, but other than that, it's pretty smooth. Probably be better than the last Bonanza video. I was out here kind of messing around today and going to fly out here for a couple hours, and so I thought it'd be a good time to do that. So out here flying along and going to walk you through the systems we've got here. I've got it all set up, and I'll go ahead and take the camera and kind of walk you through all the instruments here. But we're cruising around at about 168 miles an hour, 120 indicated, so we've got a pretty good tailwind. And so let's go ahead and walk through some of these instruments. Okay, so here's the basic layout of the panel. We've got three quadrants. The first is kind of our engine monitoring, and I'll walk through each of those. The second here is fuel, radio and transponder, as well as navigation via that Garmin 150. And then over here is the rest of our instrumentation. So I'll walk through these here in pretty good detail. Okay, so here we have our carb temperature, our voltage, our amp meter, our oil pressure, our fuel pressure, our oil temperature, our EGTs, and our CHTs. So you can see that I fly this airplane pretty cool, around 1,200 EGTs, around 320, 340 CHTs. Fuel, there's 40 gallons in this airplane, one fuel gauge for each side, obviously. There's our timer. And then this is our GPS 150 Garmin. Older, but gosh, you know, it still works. I got nothing to complain about here. Kind of walk through, and it does have a moving map. It's kind of rudimentary, and I basically only use it for direct to stuff. Then the second radio, or second down there, is the Garmin radio. Just put this in and really like it. It's all it does is communications. It's not a navcom. The only really navigation equipment in this airplane is that Garmin 150, and then we've got a Narco transponder there, Mode C. Then moving over here, we've got the tachometer. I've got manifold pressure. Don't really need manifold pressure because it's a fixed pitch cruise prop on this, a Sensen inch. Vertical speed indicator, altitude, a couple more clocks. I've got a fascination with time, obviously. Then we've got the Dynan display here. This is our artificial horizon. And it's, I like it. You know, I'm used to an Aspen or synthetic vision, but for what we're using this for, it's great. You know, no complaints. Speed indicator. And then we've got trim, left, right mag, starter, master, and master switch, and alternator. Then here is our Trio autopilot. It's on right now. And then this is our Trio altitude hold. And that's a new install as well, and I really like it. It's on right now. I'm holding it, but I can adjust this to go up or down however I want it, and it'll fly however I tell it to fly, and works really well. You know, I didn't think we had this many hours in this airplane, but I never really pay attention. But we're up to 390 hours on the meter there. So we're starting to get some material time on this airplane. Then here's our throttle quadrant here. We've got carburetor heat, cabin heat, flaps, fuel, and this is new too. This is a vernier, or you can push-pull it without hitting the button. It's kind of cool. Whoa, a little bit of turbulence there. Okay, this is mixture, and then this is music in and out. These are all of our switches here. Very cool, we like it. Very simple, dead simple to fly. Here's where I keep my iPad. So let's use it a lot in this airplane. As I said, there's no VOR equipment or anything in this airplane. It's basically just the GPS and then whatever portable GPS I have. I also have a Stratus 2S for ADS-B in. I don't hardly ever use it, mostly because I like Garmin Pilot better than ForeFlight. It's just a personal preference thing. Nothing wrong with ForeFlight. It's a great app. But I've been using Garmin Pilot a lot, so that's basically what I fly with. Alright, so I'm going to put the camera back up into its holder and then do some performance maneuvers and show you how this thing flies. Okay, so first stop here is going to be Akron. And I didn't even set direct to, I'm just watching it on the iPad, but we're going to go there and land and get some fuel. It was really cheap there. You fell. Okay. So I'm kind of direct to Akron at this point, and I've got the autopilot just set to course, and tracking along pretty well. Let's see, what the identifier for Akron is AKO, so let's just do a direct to A. So, all right, we're 37 miles out from Akron. Our ground speed is 161. All the systems look good. No complaints here. So we'll go out, land at Akron, and then make our way on to destination. So now I'll kind of, on our way there, maybe do some steep turns. Show you how I fly this thing. You know, again, as I said, that RV's got a lot of performance, and the airspeed's similar to a Bonanza in that it builds airspeed pretty quickly. So you have to watch your airspeed, particularly when you get into flaps. It's 100 miles an hour is the flap deployment speed, and it's really easy coming into the pattern to push this thing way over that. And so you just got to kind of be on the ball a little bit. So I'll show you guys all that, but between here and there, we're going to, like I said, we'll do some slow flight, maybe do some stalls, steep turns. Heck, I don't know. I'm learning this whole YouTube thing, and people say I blab a lot. I don't. But you only have 15 minutes for the video, so when you talk as much as I do, that goes quick. All right. Well, here we go. Okie dokie. So here we are. I got the autopilot off. Very small control inputs, but I'm going to do a kind of a steep turn here to the right. Do a clearing turn, and you'll see this thing just fly very nicely, very nice and smooth. It's a smooth day out here, so. There's Pikes Peak off in the distance. And there's a clearing turn. Back out to our original heading. Now when you do slow flight here, I'm going to put on the carb heat. This thing will go very, very slowly. Like I said, it's got, on the low end, it's got performance that's very similar to a Cessna, believe it or not, which is great. You know, I'm a huge fan of Cessnas. But we're slowing down. We're down to 90 miles an hour now. Putting in the flaps. And there's 80 miles an hour. And we'll slow this all the way down to 60. Maintaining altitude here. Maybe 65. So there's 65 knots, and it just, you know, wobbles around. And the stall on this airplane is pretty clean, so let's power back up here. Get the flaps out. And voila, our ground speed's all the way back up to 158, indicating 120. So there's 163. We'll go ahead and slow this thing down. But as you can see, it's a very docile. You know, like I said, the control inputs. You know, you got to be soft on the controls, but it's a very docile airplane to fly. And, you know, for what I use it for, which is this, you know, cross countries where it's just me, and it's good. Stay tuned for part two.